हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 79। व्हाट्सएप हैज सेड इन इट्स रेस्पॉन्स टू अ पिटीशन फाइल अगेंस्ट इट्स प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी अपडेट इन द इंडियन हाई कोर्ट दैट मेनी इंटरनेट बेस्ड एप्लीकेशंस एंड वेबसाइट हैव सिमिलर पॉलिसीज दैट हैव फेसबुक रिपोर्टेडली साइटेड प्राइवेसी पॉलिसीज ऑफ कंपनीज इंक्लूडिंग बिग बास्केट, कू, ओला, ट्रू कॉलर एंड जोमैटो एज वेल एज द गवर्नमेंट्स कॉन्टैक्ट ट्रेसिंग ऐप आरोग्य सेतु इन एन एफिडेविट फील इन द कोर्ट। Tech Mahindra Limited has opened a COVID-19 care unit at its Singwade Pune facility offering 25 beds, as well as healthcare and pharmacy support to COVID-19 patients. The care unit, which is for the IT firm's associates and their families, was launched in the presence of Dr. Sundar Rai, Chief Operating of Ruby Hall Clinic in Jhuwadi, which is partner Tech Mahindra for this facility. Vitalik Buterin, who is a co-founder of Ethereum, has donated $1 billion of coins to India. However, the donation has been made by Vitalik is in the form of meme digital currency called Shiba Inu coin, which has been named after the dog breed. Vitalik has also been donated in the form of Ethereum, which is his own cryptocurrency. India is currently battling the second wave of coronavirus pandemic, which is wreaked havoc. As per the reports, Buterin has donated around 500 Ethereum coins and over 50 trillion Shiba Inu coins. The Mimi coin that is worth around $1.14 billion to the India COVID-19 Crypto Relief Fund, which has also been set by the Indian tech entrepreneur Sandeep Naiwal. Elon Musk, the CEO of Tesla Motors, recently announced that the company has stopped accepting Bitcoin as payments for its car out of concern that will contribute to greater consumption of fossil fuels. As per the reports, the business magnate and SpaceX founder shared a statement on Twitter on Wednesday about the same. Tesla had only just started accepting Bitcoin in late March. The 49-year-old industrial designer also said that Tesla will no longer sell any more of the $1.5 billion stashes of Bitcoin it purchased earlier this year. Tesla sold some of the Bitcoin in the first quarter of 2021, which wound up helping pad the company's quarter profit figures. According to the statement, Tesla it would resume accepting Bitcoins and would consider selling more of it once the process of mining Bitcoin transitioned to more sustainable energy. The company also looking for other cryptocurrencies is that use 1% of Bitcoin's energy transaction. As of the writings, Tesla website indicates it will still accept Bitcoin for transactions. Cryptocurrency is a good idea of many levels and we believe it has a promising future, but this cannot come at great cost to the environment. A team of researchers from Cornell University has pioneered a new wireless charging method for electric vehicles, inspired partially by this time working at NASA. The new approach, which takes cues from NASA's method for sending data through deep space, could revolutionize EV infrastructure by enabling electric vehicles and autonomous factory machines to charge while driving. Italy's competition regulator has fined Google a 102 million euros for excluding an e-mobility app developed by Enel from the US tech giant's Android system. For more than 2 years, Google has not allowed Enel Juice Pass to operate on Android Auto, a system that allows apps to be used safely in cars, unfairly curtailing its use while favoring Google Maps, the regulator said. The contested behavior can influence the development of e-mobility in crucial phase, with possible negative spillover effects on the growth of electric vehicles. Xiaomi sub-brand Redmi today added a fourth member of the Note 10 lineup in India, the Redmi Note 10S. It comes in a deep blue sea, frost white and a shadow black color, has two memory options, 6GB and 64GB storage and 6GB RAM and 128GB storage, priced at 14,999 Indian rupees and 15,999 Indian rupees. Respectively, you can buy one starting on May 18th through mi.com and amazon.in and retail outlets across the country. Just yesterday, Poco announced that it will be extending the warranty of its smartphone in India by 2 months. This will be valid for those users whose smartphone warranty expires in May or June. Today, Vivo has come up with a similar initiative. Vivo has confirmed on its official Twitter handle today that it will be giving a service extension on its smartphone in India for a 30-day period. The announcement by both the smartphone manufacturer come in a wake of lockdown curfews implemented in multiple states in India. With these types of initiatives, users who are unable to get their device repaired in a lockdown can take advantage of the extended warranty. Realme launched the 5G variant of the Realme 8 smartphone last month in India. During the launch, the brand introduced in two RAM variants, 4GB and 8GB of RAM. Both these variants comes with 128GB onboard storage. Now, Realme has launched a new 4GB RAM and 64GB storage variant of the smartphone in the country. With this, the Realme 8 5G becomes the most affordable 5G smartphone in the country for now. To recall the smartphone with a MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor, a triple rear camera setup and a 5000mAh battery. The price for the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage is for 13,999 of Indian rupees. Xiaomi launched the Redmi Note 8 series smartphone including Redmi Note 8, Redmi Note 8T and Redmi Note 8 Pro back in 2019. Now after almost 20 months, Xiaomi might be adding another variant to the Redmi Note 8 lineup. The upcoming Redmi Note 8 series with model number M1908C3JGG appeared on the FCC certification. The FCC listing revealed that the smartphone will be powered by MediaTek Helio G85 processor and will boot MIUI 12.5 out of the box. Battlegrounds Mobile India fake download links, why should you stay away? Battlegrounds Mobile India fake download links trying to download Battleground Mobile India from these fake links ahead of its official launch is not a good idea. Earlier this year, the parent company of Moto, Lenovo, has teased its new concept for an air-to-air charging system that can charge multiple devices remotely. Now the company has announced a partnership that will further advance the development to make this technology practically available for everyone. Motorola has partnered with Guru Wireless to add support for over-the-air wireless charging system to the company's smartphone. For those who are unaware, Guru specializes in customizable over-the-air power system. That uses millimeter wave integrated circuits, modules and proprietary smart RF lensing technology. Early benchmarks comparing the M1 iPad Pro 12.9 to the MacBook Air M1 have emerged online. The iPad netted the overall score of 1,060,247 points on Antutu, while the MacBook Air was slightly ahead of the score of 1,118,243 points. The M1 iPad Pro 12.9 likely lost due to thermal throttling as the MacBook ran dissipate heat faster. Infinix is all set to expand its Hot series in the Indian market with the launch of a new budget segment smartphone called the Infinix Hot 10S. We have already witnessed a series of rumors about the handset and it is also launched in the global market. Today, the company has officially confirmed the launch date of Hot 10S among the some vital information about the handset. Infinix suggests that the launch is slated for May 20 and the smartphone will ship with a MediaTek Helio processor under Rs 10,000 mark. And this phone is confirmed to be available for purchase exclusive on the e-commerce site Flipkart. Going with official confirmation, the smartphone will come in 4 color variants including Heart of Ocean, Morandi Green, 7 degree purple and 95 degree black. In the working to expand availability around the world, Google over the years has bought Assistant to feature phone. Nokia is now launching the 2720V flip phone with Google Assistant in the US on Verizon's 4G network. The Nokia's 2720V flip is officially a smart feature phone with a 1.3-inch outer display that shows caller ID and time, day and date. The 2-megapixel rear camera is normally placed at the bottom of the phone and features an LED flash. It is made of tough polycarbonate with an exposed topping when closed. Other physical features include a 3.5mm headphone jack and a volume rocker. Vivo launched the Vivo True Wireless Earbuds alongside the Vivo Next 3 smartphone back in 2019. The company later on even debuted the True Wireless Neo Earbuds in June 2020. Now the smartphone maker is launching the successor of its first True Wireless Earbuds on May 20th. Vivo has officially confirmed today that it will be launching the Vivo True Wireless Earbuds 2 on May 20th in China. The Vivo True Wireless Earbuds 2 will be the company's first True Wireless Earbuds that will be offering active noise cancellation support. Xiaomi has just announced that its upcoming high-end notebook will launch in June 2021. The laptop in question is a new Mi Notebook Pro X, which will feature the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3050 Ti GPU. A new Samsung AR glasses design patent has been filed at Weibo. The patent description reads, "Head-mounted display. The new Samsung AR glasses have a wayfarer-like design." LiCo, the Chinese company which was once aiming to take on the likes of tech giants in the western part of the world, crumbled after facing a number of setbacks as the company was growing too fast without a solid financial foundation. Now it seems that LiCo is making a comeback. The company has shared a new product launch invitation for the Li TV Smart Ecological Conference held on 18th May. Based on the invitation, the company seems to be gearing up to launch a new smart TVs in the market. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.